Game one was a bit of a defensive struggle. Both teams seemed tight at the beginning, but it was Greeno who came to the rescue for Hartford, scoring two goals en route to a 2-1 Hartford victory in game one. Game two coming up in a few minutes right here live, LeagueGaming.com and YouTube. Hi, everyone. T-Sibs, VHigh, Moranaconda with you again for game two tonight. And we had a lot of fun watching game one last night, boys, but a little bit of shuffling around today with the lineups, and I think we are probably seeing a fairly serious Rockford team who wants to try and draw this one even as quickly as possible and not get down 2-0.
Yeah, I think there's a got to be a sense of urgency for the Rockford IceHogs tonight. You know, I think they got to get back to their basics and get back to playing their offensive style that everyone knows that they can play. They do have King of Kush over at right wing tonight instead of his normal position at center, and we'll see how that works out. No, I believe he is a lefty, so he should feel right at home over there on right wing. And Riney on left wing. They got Kyle on left D, Rask in net, and OSU Buck on right defense for Rockford. And, you know, we got to see if they can get themselves back and back on track here and put up a good game, too, here tonight against Hartford.
VHigh, what are you seeing with this one?
Well, you know, if the lineups, I guess, are set here for Hartford, we're seeing the same defensive pairing as game one. And I think it really just goes to show you that Hartford wants to set a defensive tone in this series. You know, one that they're going to be able to stop the IceHogs offense at their best. And also, you know, if they can get some offensive production out of their decor like they did last night with Greeno getting the two goals, that would be huge for the Wolfpack tonight. Shiz is obviously not playing games. He's having him and N. Riney with King of Kush on the forward ranks for the IceHogs. That's a solid offensive line. You have Kyle and OSU Bucks on D, of course, and Rask and Net. And Rockford looks to be poised and ready to go here and try and tie this series up. It's a big game for them. They don't want to get too far behind the Wolfpack.
Still waiting for the teams to gather right now. And we will be going to the game momentarily. But, you know, obviously Rockford has shown that they can come back from a big deficit. But I'm thinking against a team like this, this is not the time to get down 2-0 on a good Hartford team. And as we had mentioned in the Saturday show, and, you know, we had talked to some of the folks from Hartford, they wanted to press hard defensively. Looks like they did that pretty well last night.
For sure. I thought they played a great defensive game. Like I pointed out in the broadcast, I thought that they were keeping them to the outside. They were taking away the middle. They were collapsing well to the slot. They just did everything right defensively to keep the IceHogs at bay. And, you know, we'll see if they can continue that same luck tonight and see if they can't keep these IceHogs off the board. We do have three of the top four leading scorers in the Calder Cup playoffs playing on a line tonight in Riney, Chiz, and King of Kush. So they're going to be one heck of a trio to try and keep off the board tonight.
Well, it's actually looking like, I don't know, does Rockford have a ECU in there on right wing right now, Six?
Yeah, it looks
single
that way.
G6?
Yeah, single G6 looks to be the guy that they've got showing up in the lineup right now, and I don't know if that is a interloper on their lineup or if that is somebody for real. We'll have to check the rosters and see if that is a legit player. But Kyle Y12 also, Kyle is one of their regular players, so that shouldn't be an issue.
Just single G6. Everybody's there for Hartford, and we're about to get going here. So it is an ECU. King of Kush not in this one.
That is going to be a well, we'll see how this guy plays, but King of Kush is the second leading scorer in the playoffs right now, overtaken by Chiz Nasty last week. You know, that's a huge, you know, but hey, you know, that means that we could be seeing King of Kush centering up Kraz here in game three, possibly game four. So that does give them some firepower on another line as well.
Yeah, and, you know, game two down by one against the Wolfpack here. It's tough to have to put an ECU in there and try and get this series even against a team like Hartford. Sibs?
Well, the game is now cranking up. As you can see, Hartford and Rockford about ready to go. And we'll see if this is going to be as much of a looks like we got some play-by-play call from someone else, but we're gonna hang here and stay with the video. And face-off now about to take place as Hartford wins it, and we're underway here in game two. Right away, Hartford in Rockford zone, and we're gonna have a penalty immediately on Rockford, and that'll put the Wolfpack on the power play.
I think they're definitely going to have to try and stay out of the box as much as possible tonight, Sibs. Last night it proved to be their Achilles heel, giving up the game winner on the power play. So they're going to have to do a better job of being disciplined tonight in this game to have a chance against the strong Hartford Wolfpack team.
Hartford trying to get across the blue line, broken up, but now they get it back. And a beautiful save there by Rask, who is back in net tonight for Rockford. And so Hartford now trying to get back in. 40 seconds left to go on the power play. Puck at the point, trying to work it around, and Rockford breaks it up and gets it out of their zone. 10 seconds on the penalty. This one's almost up, and Rockford now back to even strength. Hartford still pressing, and now continuing to press and still getting sticks on it. Now a good opportunity and Rask there, but we're going to get another Rockford penalty and Hartford will go back on the power play.
Yeah, you're starting to see a little bit of a mad scramble here. Rockford needs to settle down a little bit, get this penalty killed and start moving out of their end of the ice, because if the Wolfpack continue to hold it down here, they're going to get a goal here pretty quick.
Riney controlling, gets it back behind the net, but Hartford breaks it up and starts back out again. And that looks to be SN1K now back up top to the point for a shot. Save again by Rask. Now a loose puck in front goes behind the net, and Rockford gets it cleared out. Riney again trying to work the puck along the boards, gets it up to Chiz, and now into the Hartford zone. First time a puck gets on Big Lammers, but nothing really of note there. Now back into the Hartford zone. Under 13 and a half to go in the first period. No score, game two. And Hartford again. So the power play, second one of the night, is over for Hartford, and Rockford has killed their second power play. Now trying to work in offensively, really, for the first time, but broken up and taken back as Hartford dumps it in. Still trying to work a puck along the boards. Back behind the net. Now back at the point for a shot blocked. Rockford trying to get it out. Again, intercepted, but now Rockford takes it back. Single G6 trying to work it up, and it gets broken up again by the Hartford defense, and they start back out.
Well, I tell you, the sticks for Hartford are just relentless. They seem to be in every single lane that Rockford is trying to get the puck through, and they're just relentless with their sticks. Their positioning is fantastic, and you know, they're doing a really good job.
Rockford getting their first power play of the night, and they are going to have an opportunity here to try and put their first tally and their first lead up in this series. Single now back up to the top to OSU. Takes a shot, saved by Lammers, and he'll hold. 1:17 on the power play as Chiz and Durst face off. Hartford winning the face off and now trying to get it out of the zone. Durst broken up by Chiz and now taken back by Single. Shot on net, saved by Lammers, and he'll hold, stopping the rebound. Face off to Lammers right, again won by Hartford, and they will try and kill this as they lob it down the ice, picked up by OSU Bucks, and now taken by Reine. Back up top to Kyle, now Bucks with the shot, saved by Lammers and cleared to the side.
You can see that Rockford's starting to build a little bit of offensive zone time here. They've had it down in Hartford's end just a little bit longer the last couple minutes. We'll see if they can break through.
Hartford about to get their third power play as the penalty is being called, delayed, and now finally the whistle goes, and Rockford will be again defending on the power play, and they win their faceoff in their zone and now try and clear it back out. We're under 5.5 in the first period, no score. And so far, a little bit looser play, I think, than what we saw last night. Now, a surprise wraparound by Reine, and that one is in. And now, Rockford with the early 1-0 lead.
And that is a shorthanded goal for Rockford. You know, they took a double minor and were able to score shorthanded there. That could be a big point in this game.
So we did not make note of that initially. Thanks for the update on that one, VHigh. Yes, it was a double, and they still have 2:55 left to go in this penalty kill, but have taken a 1-0 lead on a shorthanded goal by Reine. And now Hartford trying to work it. Around the boards now, back up top to the point. We're looking at Weed Farmer now back down low. Now back over from Weed Farmer and the shot save. And now that rebound is in. And did not see you got a piece of that one, but it looks like it's going to be Boomer who gets the credit for the goal.
Well, Rockford's got to stay out of the box here. They're just continually shooting themselves in the foot, and it's working against them with the EA karma, too, as their guys are having a little bit of trouble picking up loose pucks now. And, you know, Hartford's just continually pouring it on, even though they did give up that one goal. They just continue to be in the right place at the right time.
We're about 1.5 minutes left to go in the first period. The score is tied at 1. And now Rockford trying to drive in the Hartford zone. And another quick wraparound, and Rockford has put themselves up 2-1. Looks like Chiz Nasty gets credit for that goal. And Rockford now coming back after a tight start have now taken a 2-1 lead. And we're getting another penalty called.
That was an excellent goal by Chiz. I didn't really see much daylight to get that one squeaked in, but he did get it as we go here to a Rockford power play.
20 seconds left to go. Rockford on the power play. Hartford having an opportunity there, but broken up, and now they're trying to get something going in the last few seconds. Hartford with 3 seconds, trying to drive in the zone. Shot saved by Rask, and that will be the end of the first period.
Well, I think the key for Rockford here definitely going into the second period is to definitely stay out of the box. But, you know, due to the leadership of their leader currently out on the ice, Chiz, with a great play behind the net, he did give them the lead to go up 2-1 at the end of that first period. And I see if the Hogs stay out of the box here, I see them really starting to get their legs under them. They're definitely playing a lot looser in this game than they were last night. They seem to be squeezing a little bit last night, and they're kind of going for it tonight. I definitely say the key to this game here is to stay out of the box and continue to play their offensive style.
Couple of penalties from both teams right in the first period. We saw Reine open up the scoring for Rockford, giving them a 1-0 lead. Boomer came back for Hartford to tie it at 1, and then, of course, Chiz Nasty with his wraparound, making it 2-1. That's where we are now as we start the second period. Power play still for Rockford, 30 seconds left to go as they drive. Good defensive breakup by the Wolfpack, and now they are looking to kill some time. 10 on the power play for Rockford, and it will be all but over now as both teams are even strength.
And that's a big kill for Hartford there. They don't want to let this one get out of hand as there's a turnover by Rockford in front of their net leading to a goal.
Hartford, nice pickup by Durst, and he gets the goal to make it now 2-2. And that was a good intercept, as you said, VHigh. Nice play in front there for it and able to poke it home. Now Hartford with another opportunity, another good save by Rask.
Well, same thing I talked about last night. Hartford able to kill a penalty and go right down and score right after they're done killing the penalty. Seems to be a trend here for the Wolfpack. When they send someone to the box, that it seems like they're ready to get a goal back for that person who had to leave the ice.
Wolfpack dump it in, chased by OSU. Bucks tries to get it out of the zone, but broken up and taken now. Riney breaks up that pass and starts out single. And, of course, the Wolfpack solid defense is always breaking up the pass and starting back out. Wolfpack trying to drive here as we reach the 14-minute mark in the second period. And play is broken up, and now Chiz starts back out with it, gets it over to Riney. Looking to find somebody in front, gets a shot off on Lammers, who almost left that post too soon, but was able to make the save and cover up.
Well, I think the goalie will take that shot all day long. You know, the shot came from the outside. It didn't come from a very high-scoring area, and it's usually an easy save for the goaltender.
Hartford trying to work it out now. Boomer on the right against the boards, looking for somebody, gets a shot off. It's blocked up front, and now Rockford back out. And Riney now gets the puck taken off of his stick by Weed Farmer, who will now flip it and possibly over the boards, but that will not be a penalty. And it will be a face-off back in Hartford zone.
That was really close to being another penalty there by the Wolfpack.
Face-off won by Hartford. They finally get it out of the zone and now start back up. Looks like Durst is controlling the puck at this point, trying to do something with it behind the net. Some board play, and now finally whipped back up, and Rockford will take it up. This is single, working on the right side. Shot, and Lammers moved a little too far to the right, and that puck is in.
Very reminiscent of last night's first goal by Greeno as it hits the goalie pad and still slides in the short side of the post. That was a very good shot on a moving goaltender there by single.
And so now Rockford up 3-2, and Hartford having some difficulty with defense now as they are having trouble getting out of the zone, finally do after a nice save by Lammers, and now Hartford trying to work it up. Rockford with the interception. Bucks is slammed, loses the puck, and now Hartford trying to work it back in. Nice save by Rask as he gave a little bit of that post up. But now a penalty being called on Hartford, and Rockford will be back on the power play.
You can almost feel the tide of this game turning a little bit here. You know, it's starting, the bounces are starting to go a little bit Rockford's way. They just got a penalty to go on to the power play. So, you know, the tide's kind of turning here. Hartford's got to do something here big to get the momentum back in this game.
Shot from the point on the left side. Kyle with the beautiful point shot, and that one goes in. And now Rockford up 4-2. And we're seeing some names contribute here that we may not have expected before this game started, but they are part of the scoring now, both single and Kyle scoring for the IceHogs.
We'll have to see a replay on that at the intermission. That might have been deflected by Shiz Nasty up in front of the net there. But either way, very good goal for Rockford. Gives them a little bit of breathing room as they head on the power play again.
3.5 left to go in the second period. 1:40 on the power play for Rockford as they're trying to get back into the Hartford zone. They do. Single now driving. Has Chiz to the left of him. And puck went on net. Lambert's covered up.
Their ECU seems to be fitting in really well with their style of play here. Doesn't seem to be an issue at all in this game so far.
Play up front where Rockford had an opportunity on the doorstep, but Lammers was there. Now the Wolfpack start out again. 2:30 left to go in the second. 30 seconds on the power play. And Rockford will start back out again and looking to extend this lead if possible. Barely able to keep it in. No, it's called offside, and it'll be outside of the Hartford zone for the faceoff. 2:02 left to go in a second.
We may see a coach's challenge here, Sibs. That was close.
Hartford trying to work it. Chiz controlling. Pass up. Misses Riney. But that will not be an icing. Waved off, but Hartford has it, and they'll start back out with it. Now dumped in, deflected into the Rockford zone. Looks like Chiz will have it. Clears it out as the period comes to an end, and Rockford up 4-2 in this one. And the second period goals by Durst for Hartford, and then Single and Kyle with the consecutive goals for Rockford have now put them up 3-2. And we are seeing a Rockford team that has to play incredibly hard to get where they are at this point, VHigh, but they seem to be doing it and doing it well. And like you said, getting good play from their ECUs.
And that was a deflection by Chiz Nasty.
They really are getting some good play out of their ECU. But I want to talk about the Hartford Wolfpack here. I've noticed that when they have the puck and they're moving down the ice or up the ice, Rockford's doing a good job of poking it off the stick, but they do have someone following up a lot of times to pick it back up. So it's tough getting possession away from them. I think you'll see them tighten it down defensively here in the third period and try and put together a good stack of time on possession and try and get a couple of goals here as they really want to have this game.
So that last goal is, like you said, Mike, I think it is credited to Chiz. He does have two goals on the night, as we saw with the stats. As we're looking at the shots right now, Rockford with 13, Hartford with 10. Time on attack, though, is all Hartford at this point, 6:10 to 2:25. And that's interesting because just by watching the game, I'm not sure I absolutely would have seen that. But Hartford definitely has had the time on attack.
Well, the first few minutes of that game, Hartford was all over them, and the tide slowly seems to be turning in Rockford's direction here. And but there's 7 total penalties in this game, Sibs. They both teams have got to stay out of the box and keep this a clean third period.
Third period underway as Hartford tries to start their offense up. Trouble getting out of their zone. Still having some issues, and a shot on Rask is saved. Hartford still pounding, still driving. Rockford finally getting out. And we've got Single trying to get it out now. Chiz with a shot blocked. Hartford starting back out again, looking to get something going. Defense, OSU Bucks has been tremendous today and has really made it hard for them as he intercepts another puck in his zone. Starts his own offense out again. And Hartford now coming back into the offensive zone, broken up again by OSU Bucks. But Hartford able to hold on to it. Coming in, bad errant pass, but it's back out to the point. Shot partially blocked. Now again, another shot on goal for Rask, and he makes a save on the glove side.
I do want to point out OSU Bucks there. He's having a fantastic game. He did make a little bit of a mistake trying to get that puck out of the zone there, but it seems like he's keeping his guys. He's forcing them into the corner. He's taking the puck from them immediately, and he's getting it up to his forwards to get out of the zone. He's having a great defensive game tonight.
And Hartford in their own zone trying to work it. Weed Farmer now pushes it up. And now Hartford around the boards, but taken now by OSU, gets it to Chiz, and now back up to Single. Now Chiz on the right side, tries to get it over for Riney, but that one is broken up by Weed Farmer, and now back out for Hartford. 11.5 to go in the third. 4-2 Rockford as they look to bring this series even. Hartford trying to get something going, but to no avail, and it's back out at the red line.
Hartford only looks to be 1 or 2 passes away from breaking through here. But Rockford's doing a really good job of clogging the middle, and as much possession as the Wolfpack are having, they're having trouble getting the puck into Rask, and when they do, Rask is coming up big.
9 minutes to go. Third period. Rockford throws it back into the Hartford zone. And they will try and start this up again. Long pass hits no one. Icing is the call, and it'll be a faceoff back in the Hartford zone.
One thing that I'd like to say here is that I see Hartford, you know, they've kind of gotten away from their game plan in the offensive zone. Seems like they're getting pucks, and that's to credit Rockford, but they're getting pucks in deep, and then they're trying to do it all themselves. They're not making passes back up to their point men, and it's really making it tough on them, as it looks to, you know, they got to move the puck better here.
Greeno gets the pass back, throws one on net, and Hartford now pulls within one at 4-3, and I believe that was Greeno on the, Not sure about that then. I'm not sure about the name there. That may be somebody else who's at that left wing at this point.
Either way, exactly what I was just talking about. They got the puck back up to the D. They dropped it back. You know, they made a nice pass, created a lane, and were able to beat the goalie high, top shelf on the left side.
I believe it was Snick 88.
Well, there's another change I guess we missed. Or at least I missed. Oh, okay, I see what you're saying.
It does appear that Hartford has lost a player here due to a lag out, so they are down a man currently. I believe it is Greeno, possibly, who has lost connection here, which could be a big blow for Hartford. Nope, it is
Looks
Boomer.
Looks like Boomer, yeah. The right wing is lost, and so we'll see where that goes. Now, Hartford trying to drive in. We approach the five-minute mark, and they're looking to tie this one up. Back out to the point for Weed Farmer. He moves in behind the net. Poke check by OSU, breaks it up. Now, Hartford still maintaining possession. And a shot deflected and blocked. And, again, Hartford barely able to keep it in. Not now it's offsides. As Weed Farmer tried to keep it in, poking it out of the air, but it just was offside.
That was a great offensive zone possession by the Wolfpack, and they're going to need a little more of that to try and get this thing tied up in the last 3 minutes here.
Hartford still driving hard. Pass in front, and a puck slips through, and it is a goal, and that one ties it up at four.
Well, it doesn't look like they had to keep it up very much longer. They were able to break through pretty quickly there, and a lot of that comes off winning the draw right outside the offensive zone.
That was a great keep to keep that puck in the zone there. That was a great play. They got the puck to the net, and, you know, good things happen when you get the puck to the net, and they were able to dribble one in there and tie this game up, go with 2 minutes left in the third period here.
Durst with the goal ties it up, and so now under two. And we have another barn burner going, a 4-4 game as icing is now called on Hartford, and they will have to defend with 1:33 left to go in their own zone. Hartford wins the faceoff, but it is taken now by Reine. He's controlling, tries to get it in front, but broken up, and Hartford will start out. Looks like Durst is controlling again and again. Gets a shot to the right side of Rask, almost goes in, but now a floater from the right defense, and that one goes in.
That was a great deflection. That was a great deflection right there in the high slot. He was able to get just enough of that to make it go far post right over the goalie's shoulder. That's a great job of screening the goalie and staying in position in front of the net there, and, you know, had a great deflection. Good set of hands there.
That was a huge opportunity there missed by Rockford at the other end with Reine. He was in there on the goalie and tried to make a pass instead of putting one on net. Not that it's his fault that the goal just went in, but it did get turned around the other way by Hartford, who was able to bury it and take a lead after being down by two not too long ago.
So as you say, it looks like it was a deflection in front, and it looks like they will give it to Snake as the go-ahead goal. We've got 47 seconds left to go in this one. Hartford with the one-goal lead, and they start out on offense trying to keep pressure and keep possession. Now taken up by Rockford, and a long pass to Reine. broken up again by the Hartford defense as they start out with 27 seconds left to go in the third. Still maintaining possession. And now, finally, OSU gets it out to Riney, and they start out. Now Single tries to get in front for Riney. Pass broken up, but the puck is tipped in, and it looks like Chiz Nasty may have been able to poke that one in with 13.2.
And his game-tying goal here gives him the hat trick as well. And definitely the biggest goal of the game for Chiz Nasty there. Couldn't come at a better time for Rockford.
And so, again, another late goal has put this game at 5-5. And we have 13.2 left to go in the third period. And this may or may not go to overtime, but we'll see what happens. Hartford throws it deep into the Rockford zone. They are able to wave the icing off and beat it. Puck in front, but now broken up and taken back by Kyle. And the period has ended. What a flurry of activity in the third period. Four goals. Hartford looked like they were in control with three straight in the third period. But Chiz Nasty, with 13.2 left to go in the third period, was able to knock one home and tie this up at five.
That is just a great job by Chiz to drive through to the net there. He knows the puck's going to be getting to the crease there. He does the right thing by getting to the crease, looking for that loose puck, finding it, and putting it past the goaltender. That's a great job by Chiz Nasty. That's a great job by Rockford to get to the puck to the net and tie this game up and take it to overtime. That's a huge, huge job. And we're going to have a restart here due to the lag out. They're going to get their guy back. So that's a great job by the Hogs to tie that thing up and push it to overtime.
Yeah, and, you know, as good as Rockford feels about tying this game up like that, which is a big deal for them because they were about to be down 2-0 with about 13 seconds to go there. But on the other side of that, Hartford still has to be very satisfied with this one going to OT because with 5 minutes to go, they were down by two, and they were able to take a lead even though they gave up another goal. They were able to get this thing tied, and now you get to start all square in overtime with a fresh period and play till the first team can find the way to hit the back of the net.
Well, again, we have to take a look at the shots on goal when all is said and done, but right now it's really interesting to see that we are at one of these 5-5 games, one of these high scorers, and, you know, we talked a little bit about it on Saturday. I still feel like this kind of game where there's a lot of goals back and forth kind of works in Rockford's favor, but maybe not as much as we thought. Hartford is playing just as well offensively with them, and I don't know if that's a surprise, but it's certainly an interesting thing that they're able to really keep pace with them. I don't see Rockford having such offensive domination in this game as they definitely had in some of the other series. Hartford can skate with them man-to-man on the front line.
Well, Hartford's going toe-to-toe with them tonight, Sibs. They're doing a great job. It almost seems like these teams are mirror images of one another tonight. They're both playing really well. I still love the way that Hartford is always in the passing lanes. They're always breaking shots up, passes up. Their sticks are always in the lanes. Their bodies are always in the lanes. Like I said, they're a well-coached team, but, you know, they're mirror images of each other tonight, and they're both playing very well hockey, very good hockey. It is a 5-5 game here, and it's anybody's game going into overtime, guys.
So I have to ask, are you making a sandwich back there behind the curtains, or what's going on? I totally agree with you there, and to be honest, it's going to be interesting here. All the momentum that was built up there in that game with being down 4-2 for Hartford, bringing it back, getting it to 5-4, Chiz Nasty burying the hat trick goal to tie the game with 13.2 seconds left. And they did have the lag out, so now they have to restart. And as far as the video game goes, zero momentum until the puck drops. And we'll have to see how well each of these teams, with the little bit of a delay going into overtime, having to reset the room, which ones are going to be able to keep the fire up here and get that overtime goal, that huge overtime goal that could either tie this series or put Hartford one step closer to a repeat championship title here.
Well, they're getting back into the room and they're about ready to get kicked off again. Looks like we have everybody back who was playing, and so we should be good to go with this. Boomer is back in there. He was the one who disconnected and was not there for a good chunk of the third period, but now they have him back, and that definitely is a huge help for these guys.
Well, it's a clean game starting overtime here. Yeah. It's a clean game. There's no momentum. There's no nothing here.
Go ahead.
Well, we're just waiting for the period to start up here, and looks like, again, nobody has left completely. We're in pretty good shape here, and we're about to start the overtime here at game two, and we are finding that this is a pretty interesting and fun series between these two teams who are maybe better matched than we had hoped for. We're getting the series that we were hoping we'd get, and now overtime has started.
Yeah, and I look to see if Hartford can get that relentless forecheck back going, or if they're going to...
Well, it looks like somebody disconnected again. They just quit out, yeah. So...
Or they forgot to take the penalty, and they're restarting due to the...
Or they could be doing that. Yes, exactly.
Yeah, we'll have to see what happens here. Just to point out as well, I'm not sure that single is an ECU for King of Kush. They might have put somebody else in an ECU for him because King of Kush is watching this game and commenting in the the chat box on Twitch. So it must have just been a last-minute strategy change by Shiz in the lineup being the home team, and he can change up till game time.
And I wonder about that rule. You know, it's obviously if there is an emergency of some kind, you know, you let that go. But I'm not so sure that I'm keen on the idea that you could switch up at the last second with your roster. I feel like there's got to be a point where you have to lock that in. But
that's all part of the home ice advantage, Sibs. It's a little bit of a thing built into the game here. You know, it's not, of course, it could be an ECU too. We never know. We won't know until after the game when we speak with Chiz to see what, you know, just what happened there. But, you know, no biggie. I mean, it is a little bit of an advantage, but not too bad.
So, let's see. We again, just to recap the scoring in the first, Riney got Rockford out there with a goal at 14:54 to put them up 1-0. Boomer then responded with a goal of his own for Hartford, making it 1-1. And Chiz closed out the scoring in the first period with his first of three goals to make it 2-1 Rockford. Hartford came back in the second, Durst with his first of two goals to tie it up at two, then two straight from Single and Chiz Nasty. And that made it Rockford 4-2 after two periods. In the third, Snake with his first goal, tying the game up, and then Durst coming back with his second goal, putting Hartford in front by one, tying the game up, and then we had Snake with another goal, and then Chiz tying it up with 13.2 left to go in the third period, sending us to overtime. And that's where we stand right now as the teams are, again, getting ready to fire this one back up. And we will momentarily be having a startup of overtime.
And, well, I think what is going to be possibly a big story for the rest of this series here could be this game. This could be a turning point as you had several different storylines here, and now it's overtime in Hartford yet again in another overtime playoff game. We know that they're undefeated in overtime playoff games still. So that's something else to look at here as we head into an overtime in game two of the Calder Cup Finals between Rockford and Hartford.
Those three straight by Hartford in the third period after being down 4-2, put them up 5-4. Looked like they might be able to hold on, but again, Chiz Nasty with that poke in put the game back even at five. And Hartford trying to take a penalty having a little difficulty getting it over the boards. And now they do, and a penalty will be called. So Rockford will go on the power play from the disconnect from Boomer and try and put themselves ahead.
Pressure's on when millions of people are watching.
Chiz tries to get over for Riney, but the puck not there for a shot. Now a push in by Kyle is no good, and Rockford will have to start back out. Single. Shot on net, saved by Lammers. Hartford dumps it, killing the penalty with 50 left to go in this Rockford penalty in overtime. Chiz nasty. Back up to OSU. He's offsides. Pulls the puck back, and this will be outside the zone.
Chiz is doing a really good job here possessing the puck, giving his teammates time to get to open ice. We'll see if that's effective here at the end of this shift.
Single trying to get a short side. Top shelf shot off. He does that, but Lammers is there with the glove, and we'll get another faceoff. 9 seconds left in the power play as Hartford wins the puck. Off the faceoff, clears, and that'll do it. Teams are even strength now. Under 17 minutes left to go in the third period. And Rockford trying to start out. Long pass is not made, but there is no icing, and Rockford able to pick it back up and wraps it home.
No goal. No goal. We have a challenge here. Well, did they run into the goaltender, Sibs? I didn't quite catch it.
Well, I believe they did. So they did. Shiz Nasty buried it after the goaltender got bumped. So looks like this one. We'll see how it turns out. Shiz has the goal as of right now. But it looks like the goaltender was bumped a little bit.
Now a single G6 who tried to do the wraparound. Let's see what the call is. They're going to call it a goal. And Rockford wins this one in overtime. And they're giving
outstanding.
They're giving it to Single. They're crediting him with the goal. He was on the initial wraparound. And that will do it.
Single. That's a tough way to lose in overtime there, Sibs.
That is a brutal way to lose, but on a refereed call, and guys, I wonder, is this something that the league could review? Is this something that they would take a look at if it is something that Hartford wants challenged? Can they do that?
Absolutely not. Nope. The goaltender interference rule is there strictly for goaltenders interfering with skaters. It's not for goals. It's not for running into the goalie and causing a goal. It's strictly there for goaltenders that go out and try to run into skaters to draw penalties for their team to put their own team on the power play. So that is non-challengeable. The game is over. That's a victory to Rockford.
Wow. That was a interesting ending, and coming off of a penalty kill, looked like Hartford might be able to pick up some momentum and move back in and get something going offensively, but they were not able to do that, and Rockford has pulled this one out and made the series now a 1-1 affair going into game 3 and 4 tomorrow night, and oof, that's the kind of action that I think Rockford wants to see. They want the puck flying around. They want some loose play, and I think they definitely got it tonight.
Yeah, they did. That was a well-fought game, both sides. Just back and forth. Rockford looked to have a comfortable lead. Gave up the 3 late goals. Went down 5-4 and late in the third period. Just when it looked like it was over for them, Shiz Nasty buries his hat trick with 13 seconds to go, like you said. Then it goes to overtime. And, like we've said a million times, no good goals go in overtime. It's always, pardon my language, shit goals. And, I don't know if that one's necessarily that blatant as far as the word I used, but it's never a clean shot from the slot or one timer. It's always something crazy that happens, and it's a tough way to lose for Hartford, but I expect this series to be back and forth all the way through to the end.
I think this is just the type of game you want as a viewer, you want a hard fought, you know, overtime game with a little nip of controversy in it. You know, you got a 1-1 series going into games 3 and 4 tomorrow night. You know, I think this does nothing but builds the rivalry and really gets these teams, you know, really wanting a piece of one another. I think it's a great way to start this series, having this series tied up 1-1, and it's going to do nothing but benefit the viewers moving forward here and really help to drive this rivalry that the Rockford and Hartford Wolfpack are really starting to build here.
Well, I tell you what, we are going to get at least, I'm thinking we're going to get at least a 6-game series and maybe very well a 7-game series. You know, after the play we've seen in the first two guys, I don't think your picks are probably going to change, but do we see this one going 6 or 7 pretty easily?
I do. I think that these are just two teams that, you know, are going to be trading punches. That's what we've seen so far. You've seen it with the result of game one and game two, but you also saw it as the storyline for game two as it went back and forth, back and forth, back and forth. I expect the series to do the same as a whole, as these teams are very evenly matched. You know, where Rockford has strengths, you know, the Wolfpack have strengths to match them, and that usually calls for extra games, as we know we'll at least get to 5 now. And we are going to try and have Shiz Nasty on here in just a minute to do a quick post-game interview.
Well, again, he has been playing tremendously, I think, in this postseason. He has shown that he absolutely has upped his game in the playoffs, played well once he came over to Rockford. But, you know, I think in this playoff run, we have seen some of the best play out of Chiz Nasty and certainly the whole team. But I don't think there's any question about it, Mike. I think Chiz has definitely not only taken on the responsibility of this team, but feeling like he probably needs to show by example.
I think he's starting to really start to feel comfortable with this team. You know, he's starting to know the guys that he's playing with. He's starting to learn the ins and outs of each player. You know, he's starting to get real comfortable, and a comfortable Chiz Nasty is something that you don't really want to be going up against. You know, he can play with the best of them. When he's definitely in the dot, he's at his best. You know, and he's really started to turn it up, and he's the leading scorer in the playoffs right now. So, you know, he's definitely he's upped his game, and, you know, what a better time to up your game than in the Calder Cup Finals, right, guys?
Yeah, there's absolutely not. And Shiz has done a really good job of coming in and leading that team after all the turmoil, especially with the start of the playoffs as they lost the first two games of each of those first two series. Made sure that didn't happen in series 3. Here through 2 games, they're tied at 1 for the first time. But he as a individual is starting to heat up and play really well with whoever he's on the ice with. And yes, if he is playing like this consistently the rest of this series, he's going to be tough to beat when he's on the ice. That's for sure.
Well, I'm definitely looking forward to talking to Chiz when he comes on here, just because I think it'd be interesting to talk to him about a strategy of the lineup, what he went with tonight, and you know, hopefully what he's going to be doing in the next couple of games, because I think he spread out some of his talent. Like we were talking about earlier, we haven't even seen some of the some of the other top forwards on this team yet. And as we speak, Mr. Chiz Nasty shows up for us and is here to talk about this fantastic game and his overtime win. Congratulations on pulling this series up to 1-1 now.
Can you hear me?
Yep.
Yeah, we can hear you.
Now we can't.
We can hear you. I don't know if you can hear us, though.
Give me two seconds.
Okay. Now we can.
Yeah, I can hear you right now. Quit touching it.
Well, there we go. There you go. Hey, we were just saying congratulations on this win. A tough one all the way through, but you guys were able to come back, pull this one out late in the game, and then win it on a obviously a refereed call at the end there. But what did you see on that final play? It looked like there may have been a little bit of interference, but you know, obviously the referee on the ice there called it good.
Well, you know, it looked like he was pretty close for interference, but what they were reviewing it for was that I shot the puck and it went off G6's skate. So, you know, that's what they were looking for. I guess the kicking motion went in there, and obviously there's no kicking motion on there. I knew he was going to wrap, and I was just wondering if, you know, if the goalie was going to stop it or not. I kind of thought he'd stop the first one, and I was just going to be there to bang home the rebound. So it's exactly what happened, and I guess G6 stole my goal by tipping it with a skate.
Yeah. After watching that game, I have to imagine you have a little more shiz nasty going on like last time, huh?
Yeah. I mean, I'm not necessarily want to show tonight because I'm wearing a lighter colored shirt for sure, but no, it was a good game. I mean, I certainly didn't play it to my capabilities. It was kind of tough because I haven't played 16 since game 5 of the Condor series there, and I haven't touched it till about an hour ago, and then decided I should probably like play at least a period, and it felt so slow, it felt sluggish, and definitely wasn't myself out there. But I mean, hey, at the end of the day, we got the W, and that's all that matters.
Yeah, and you had a really big game tonight. You put away 3 goals. Not the least important of which was that goal you shot with 13.2 seconds left in the third period to tie the game. What were you feeling as it was coming down there and you guys knew you had to get that game tied up?
You know, I think at the start we did a horrible job of, you know, just sticking to some simple plays. You know, I personally was trying to make things look a little harder than it was. And, you know, they got a couple goals where, you know, they weren't pretty. They were just like, the one was a shovel backhand tip from the point. I was just like, oh my God, is that going to be the goal that loses us this game? I couldn't believe it. I was like, it's like, please, is somebody up there? Like, something's going on right now. But, you know, so at the end of the, once we started falling apart there, I was just kind of like, you know what, we just got to keep things simple. We got to crash the net. We got to put pucks on net. And then things started going our way. And, you know, sometimes you got to do that. Sometimes it's not going to be the prettiest, but if you come up with the win at the end of the night, then that's really all that matters.
Is that what you guys were thinking right there, was just get the puck to the net at all costs? I mean, with 13 seconds left, I mean, it's at that point, it's just get it to the net and bang it in, right?
Yeah, and that's exactly what I was – that's what I was saying. I said, you know, no forced passes and just get the puck to the net. And then I saw them coming down the side there, and I knew I just had to crash that net. If it was shot in or if there was a kicked-out rebound, I was going to be there to bang it in. And sure enough, I had to bang her in there for the Hattie.
You guys had a after your second goal, you guys had a 4-2 lead. Looked like you were playing more of your type of game. First period, maybe not so much. Again, I think it was a little bit of a struggle to get the offense going. They were playing good defense. You had control, it looked like, after the second. What did Hartford do differently to get them back in and start to take over the third period?
Well, you know, off the first period, I really got that 17 beta to 16 lag. I felt like I was in cement there. And, like, I have no idea. I got to check back what my faceoffs were, but they were atrocious. I've never struggled that much on the dot in my life. Oh, my God.
Yeah, it did look like Hartford. it did look like you were dealing with Durst and having a hard time on the faceoffs. They were winning a lot in their zone, which wasn't helping you guys out early.
No, and even when we had the – we had the that leg out there when they had to shoot the puck over the glass. They I was even trying to win the faceoff where they shouldn't where I shouldn't have and just let them take the puck, but they still won it anyway. So I was just really frustrated. I was like, oh, I'm glad I wasn't winning that one, but I don't know what was going on. I just couldn't win any faceoffs.
Hey, yeah, well, go ahead.
So tonight the Wolfpack made a strategic change before the game, and they put Greeno and Weed Farmer in after the success with Greeno last night. You guys were able to do a really good job of shutting them down later in the game. Until that last 5 minutes when they were able to start, they got those three goals. What strategy did you guys employ throughout the game to get yourselves back in it like that? Because we saw the tides turn around 5 minutes or so into the second period where you guys started to pick up a lot of steam.
I kind of threw out my third line there nice and bright and early to see if Beefy would change his lineup at all. And sure enough, he changed the D pair he had last night. And so I was kind of excited to see that change. And then I got to play one of their top D pairs for sure. And, you know, it was just, like I said, we needed to keep things simple. And, you know, you're not going to come and toe drag and through the legs deke Greeno and Weed Farmer. That's just not going to happen. So you really need to attack their forwards on that line, and you need to, you know, just get the puck moving, try to get their D to the fall out of position, because they're so good positionally. And as you saw, like, their poke checks and their puck pickups were unbelievable. There was passes where I thought that were there for sure, and nope, ends up on Weed Farmer's stick. So
they always seem to get a stick or a leg or something in the lanes, don't they, Chiz?
Yeah, no, definitely. I don't get if Rama's their you know, their go-to guy in NEA sports, and, you know, maybe they've got a behind the scenes guy, but no, it definitely seems to be working for them. They're a good team.
They really are. Well, congratulations on the win tonight. You got the hat trick. We're able to tie the game late in the third, and you helped the boys get it done in overtime. You have the series tied at one. Big night tomorrow night with two games. Good luck the rest of this series, and look forward to maybe talking to you again. Thanks, Chiz.
Perfect. Thanks, boys. See you later.
Thank you, buddy.
Buddy, good luck.
Chiz Nasty with the hat trick tonight joining us. And, boy, I tell you what, you know, from this afternoon, that front line lineup changed for Rockford drastically. And they went with a line that, you know, I'm not sure if G6 has played a lot with Chiz and Riney, but he sure looked like he had been.
He looked comfortable for sure. I 100% agree. He was making plays with the puck in the offensive zone where he was kind of dangling it around a little bit. But he was making passes to the right spots at the right times for the most part. It seemed like he knew where Chiz was going to be or where N. Riney was going to be on the other side. And they didn't skip a beat with him in. You know, he wasn't the reason for sure that that game had as many goals as it had, because he looked very positionally sound and had good chemistry with Chiz and Riney tonight. That's for sure.
So now one has to wonder where they're going as far as a lineup is concerned for the next game. And, you know, we like I said before, Chiz came on, you know, he's still got a few guys on that roster that haven't seen time yet who are also, you know, big offensive players for them. And the question is going to be, what's he going to do next time around? He's not going to be the home team, and so he's going to need to get a roster in earlier. And I, you know, may not think that that's that big of a deal, what time you can get the roster in, but the way this series is going and the matchups that they're trying to do, I actually think it's kind of a big deal of being able to take your time with the roster.
They're going to get that home team advantage for sure. It's, I mean, they can kind of disguise what they want to do and hope to draw out a different, you know, draw out a lineup and maybe catch catch them with their pants down.
Well, they, you know, Chiz did say he had a strategy with that this morning, and it seemed to work in his favor. But now, heading into game three, Beefy has the ability the next two games to employ the same strategy. The only disadvantage that he has is that Greeno and Weed Farmer have played their two games. So we know we're going to be getting a new defensive pairing each of the next two games for Hartford. Which one it'll be, I'm not sure. We'll find out. But, you know, we're definitely going to see both of the other two defensive pairings these next two games. And, you know, we'll see how Beefy's able to match up each of those defensive lines and what strategy he uses to match them up against Rockford's top player in Kraz 18, who hasn't even taken the ice yet.
Well, again, final score in this one in overtime. It was Rockford 5 and Hartford 4. Chiz Nasty with the hat trick. Again, Boomer with a goal early on. But Chiz Nasty had the hat trick for Rockford. Durst with a couple of goals for Hartford, but not able to come out with it. Final thoughts, Mike, from you?
Well, final thoughts are, you know, my player of the game tonight obviously goes to Chiz. He had a great game, banging in that game-tying goal to send it to overtime with 13 seconds left. You know, he may have felt a little sluggish, but he was all over the ice tonight and did a great job out there. I think looking forward to tomorrow night, games 3 and 4. You know, I think the Wolfpack, you know, don't need to change much. You know, that game was close. It was right there to be had. You know, they need to keep with their defensive style, playing their team game. I don't think they need to change much, but they know that come next game, they're gonna be staring Kraz 18 right in the face, and he's gonna be coming at him with his line mates, and I'm sure Goose Chuck's gonna be back there as well on the defensive side. So they're gonna have a tough time dealing with them. So they gotta just continue to do their thing, you know, keep playing their defensive style, and I think we're gonna be in for a couple of slobber knockers tomorrow night.
Yeah, we tomorrow night we might see many different things play out, but I think one thing we will see are two great games. You know, I don't know how they're going to turn out tomorrow. I can't get a gauge on this series based on the first two games. You know, Wolfpack looked really good starting this game. It looked like they might have the answer two nights in a row. But Rockford was able to crack the puzzle there with Chiz, and I agree, player of the game for sure. He did a lot more than score three goals and assist, have the primary assist on the game-winning OT goal. But he was very positionally sound in the defensive zone and did a good job helping out OSU Bucks and Kyle clogging up the middle there when Hartford was trying to get those chances. So, yeah, I'm ready to see these two games tomorrow, see how this series continues to unfold. It should be really fun.
I think that does it for us as we will – head on out of here. Be back on tomorrow night for games 3 and 4. And again, as always, T-Sibs, VHigh, Moranaconda, we will see you guys tomorrow night for game 3 of the Calder Cup Finals, AHL, PSN, and LeagueGaming.com. Have a good night, everyone.